Now, in this video, we are going to see using of clock with the RS flip-flop. If you give a clock as an input for the flip-flop, what will happen? In the previous one videos, what we have seen is RS flip-flop and SR flip-flop without clock. Because whenever you change the input or output, immediately it changes. There is a change here, but I want to control this. After I give the clock pulse, even if I change this, after I click give clock pulse only, this has to change. I want to give one extra control, then you have to go for a clock signal. Now we'll see that how to give the clock signal. Now we'll see the clock RS latch. This is how you draw the diagram. So these are all the NOR gate and this is an AND gate. Through this, one of the input will be clock. And here you give the R input. So when R is zero, okay, when R is zero and when you give the clock signal, positive, let us say this works in positive clock edge degree. So during the positive, that is rising edge, the data will be input. If R is one, that data will be input and Q becomes zero, right? Because here R is flip flop. If S is one only, Q will be set. This is the condition. When both are one, which is forbidden. The forbidden state I'll show you last, because if I give the forbidden state, the circuit will stand still. So I'll show you the other things. Finally, I'll show you when it is how it becomes a forbidden state. Now I'm going to draw the circuit. We'll take this NOR and gate. So one of the input is clock pulse for this, another input is the R and S. And this is S, and here we give the clock signal. So clock signal you can find under wiring. If this is a clock. See here, you can see whether it is a, when you click that you can see the operation. Okay. So now we'll see. Let me write the, this is an R and this is S. And here we have Q and Q bar. Okay. Now we'll connect it to the output. Right. Now here, first let me give the inputs. So what is the truth table? I'll explain this truth table. When both are zero, now we have extra control called clock. Now this shows the rising edge. A rising edge, edge triggering, you can show it like this, upward arrow. When it is a downward arrow, you know that, you will know it works during the negative edge triggering. Now we are going to work on the positive edge triggering. So let us take this. So upward arrow. Now 0, 0 means Q and Q bar. There will be no change. So whatever may be the previous state, we don't know whatever it is, but it remains there. Now we change it. S equal to 0 and R equal to 1. Now when I give S equal to 1, R equal to 0, R equal to 1 and S equal to 0, still there is no change because the data is not getting inside. Okay, you can see there is no change. Now I want to give the clock pulse. Now this is the positive edge triggering. The previous one, when it is that, it is a negative edge triggering. Okay, now it goes from positive, okay, the rising edge. This is what positive edge triggering, which is shown here in the logistic. Now you can see when R is 1, and S is 0, and after the clock pulse is positive edge triggering, you can have Q bar as to 1 and Q is 0. That is what here. See, S is 0, R is 1 during the positive edge triggering, Q is 0 and Q bar is 1. And the condition is said to be reset, and we say the flip-flop is storing a 0. Clear? Now again I'll make 0. Now I have made 0. Now what you know? When both are 0, it remembers the previous state. That is for new chain. The previous one is this. Now let me give this. This is a negative edge triggering. Of course, there is no chain. Now again, I'm giving the positive edge triggering. So you can see during the positive edge triggering, there is no chain. That means when both are 0, it remembers the previous state. Now let us come here. SS1. Okay. So why it has changed immediately? Because now it is in positive edge triggering. Let me take 0. Okay, now this is negative edge triggering. See here, during negative edge triggering, there is no change. Now I give, there is no change. Okay, so now again I am giving, because still it is storing 1 only. Now I am converting this both, I am giving 0. And then here you can see it is remembering whatever is changed, because here both are 0. So it is remembering the previous day. Now let me take another one, because I have shown you immediately they are changing. So 1 and 0, see here, there is no change because it is negative. Now positive edge triggering, it goes there. Now again I give. Okay, now we'll see. So what are the conditions we have seen? 0, 0, during the positive, it remembers the previous day. Then 0, 1, the value of Q is 0 and it is, which is said to be the flip-flop is storing 0. Then 1 and 0, what happens? See here. Now I change this. Now, see here. I have given 1 and I have given 0, which means Q must be 1, but it is not changing because this extra control. During the positive edge triggering, during the positive edge triggering of the clock only, it will change. See here, now it has changed. Now I am giving both 0. There is no change. Even if it is positive edge triggering is on, there is no change. Now I give a negative. Again, I'm changing it to positive. Still, there is no change. Because it is both are 0 and it is remembering. Now, the main condition, forbidden, invalid condition. Now I am going to give 1. Then this whole circuit becomes invalid. I'll show you that. See here. All becomes 0. And see, I'm not able to do anything after that. Whatever I have, I'm not able to do. See, this is, and this is said to be an invalid condition. You cannot do anything further with this circuit. Now we'll see the clock signals, okay, the changing of the inputs along with the clock signal. This can be explained with the timing diagram. This diagram is said to be timing. This is said to be timing diagram. That's like how we call this as a truth table, this as a logic circuit. This representation of the input along with its output and the clock signal is said to be the timing diagram. Okay, so how you can represent this timing diagram? Now I'll show you. Okay, now see here. Now if you see, right. Now, if you see this, see here, clock signal. Already I told you it is a square signal. Okay, now it is a square signal. The clock will change from one position to another. That is low to high, high to low to high, etc. in a correct interval, in a specific interval. So, say for example, here it is 1 and it will remain there for some time and then it will change. It is not like that. If this takes half second, this says half seconds. So, 1 full seconds, it depends upon the clock timing. Okay. So, anyway, this rising and lowering will have the equal timings. So that's why it's called clock signals. Now we'll see S, the input signals, S, R, and these are all the output signals. Now we'll see how it changes. I already told you it is in the rising edge of the clock only. There will be change in the output. Now we'll see the input. First, let us say it is in high. High means 1. S is 1. Then we have given it is low for some time. Then here that is raised. This depends because we change the S input. Okay. So it is user input. So let us consider it. Here it is high, here it is low, here it is high and so on. Then R also we consider here it is low for some time, then high and low like this. Now we are going to see how the output behaves in this condition with the clock pulse. Now, when you see Q is low because even if set is high, what is the RS condition? When S is high, the Q also will be high. But here it is low because clock pulse, before that the clock pulse was zero, the Q is zero and the clock pulse here is negative H degree. So, there won't be any change. Okay, it remains. Let us consider the previous condition is what? Here low and here high. Naturally, if it is low, it is high. Isn't it? That is what the condition. Then here there is no change because it remains low. Clock is low. So there is no change in the output. Whatever change you have, it will not have any effect. Then you are rising. The clock signal is rising. Now when it rising, it sees that S is set and R is zero. So now immediately there is a rise in the output, that is high. Okay, and it goes there till where it remains because here it is high, after that it goes slow. But clock signal is high, okay, the positive edge triggering is high. So even if it goes slow, since the clock signal has raised and it remains there, there is no change. The output will change during the next rising edge only. That is why here it has raised and the output has changed. But the output is not changed because here S is gone low. I said when S is zero, Q also will be zero. But here it doesn't change because here the clock signal is raised and here it is low. There will be no change. It will be the during the next clock pulse only, there will be change in output. So it will remain there till the next clock pulse. Output is 1 till the next clock pulse. Okay. Now we'll see this condition. Here R is high. Q bar is the opposite of that. So whatever is Q, you just put the Q bar in the opposite way. Now here again there is a rising edge. At that rising edge, it checks what is the input. Here S is 0 and R is high. Okay, which means reset high. So now what happens when S is low, that is zero, that input immediately it reflects. See, during this rising edge, the Q goes low and it remains there till the next clock pulse. So when the next clock pulse, what happens? It again checks S and R. Here S is also zero, R is also zero. So when both are zero, what happened? It remembers the previous state. Previous state, before this, what is the previous state? Q is zero and Q bar is 1. So still it remains. This is how you explain the timing diagram.